unreserved and platform tickets, and Go India Smart Card scheme for cashless purchase of UTS and PRS ticket. For the Divyang, we introduced one-time registration for availing concession while booking tickets online. Also wheelchairs and braille-enabled new coaches. For our senior citizens and women travelers, we increase quota of lower berths in the coming financial year. We are increasing the senior citizen quota per coach by 50%, resulting in almost 120 lower berths per train for senior citizens. We added more escalators and lifts, reserved more middle bays in coaches for women security. We introduced Wi-Fi services at stations, especially for our youth and business travelers. The process has begun. We intend to commission Wi-Fi services at 100 stations this year and 400 more stations in the next 2 years. We are partnering with Google in this endeavor. I take this opportunity to invite all other service providers and entrepreneurs to partner with us in this initiative. The passenger experience is significantly governed by the efficiency and quality of services on the railway stations. Besides improvement in service, a redeveloped railway station would also provide opportunities for generating significant non-tariff revenues. We are redeveloping our stations using different models. Based on one of these models, the contract for redevelopment of first station Habibganj in Bhopal, for which the financial bid has been received, while 4 others are in a very advanced stage of bidding. In a landmark decision, Cabinet has approved redevelopment of 400 stations through PPP. This is expected to be the largest transit-oriented development in the world and hence involves complex decision-making. On the basis of a bankable structure for private partnership, it is proposed to undertake a bidding process for a few large and medium stations during the course of the next financial year. Apart from taking up stations through PPP mode, we are also exploring the possibility of availing multilateral financial investment for the development of southern other stations with the state governments. We are making a unique attempt to combine cleanliness with creativity. I had appealed to numerous social organizations to come forward to beautify our stations. I am happy to inform that walls of many stations have been converted to murals, which have not only improved the aesthetics but also spread awareness on socially relevant themes. One such theme that deserves special mention is wildlife conservation, illustrated to the paintings done at Sawai Madhopur station. Hazaribagh, Borivali, Khar, Udaipur, Bikaner, of some of other stations, we showcase local art and talent. I thank them all and request similar support next year for aesthetic upgradation of our station. To provide better security to our passengers, especially women travelers, All India 24/7 helpline number 182 was started. CCTV surveillance provided at 311 stations, and all major stations will be brought under CCTV surveillance in a phased manner. A single accident or loss of a single life causes me great sorrow and anguish. It also demonstrates that we'll have to go a long way to go in realizing our objective of a zero accident regime. Although our safety record is better at 20% lower accident this year as compared to the previous year, there is much more that is required to be done. I truly believe that a way forward is to eliminate accident is through adoption and assimilation of latest technology. We have entered into R&D partnership with leading railway institutions of the world, Railway Technical Research Institute of Japan, Korean Railway Research Institute. They will work with us to improve operations on existing network and hence provide a roadmap for zero accident railway system in India. In the interim, we have examined the recommendations of the committee headed by Dr. Kakodkar and are working on their implementation. We are also working on anti-falling measures for overcrowded trains, mainly in the suburban sections. In 2015-16, we have closed 350 unmanned level crossings and eliminated 1,000 unmanned level crossings. 820 ROBs and RUBs have been completed in the current year, and work is going on 1,350 more. In my last budget speech, I had promised annualized saving of rupees 3,000 crores to be achieved by the third year on energy. I am happy to announce that a target will be achieved in the next financial year itself, a year earlier than envisaged. For the first time, we leverage provisions of the Electricity Act to procure power directly at competitive rates using our status as deemed distribution licenses. Power procurement contracts already signed and implemented will mean an annualized saving of rupees 1,300 crores. Further actions to source power already initiated will deliver annualized saving of 1,700 crores during the coming year, taking the total to Rs. 3,000 crores. In addition, the saving of Rs. 300 crores is being targeted through demand-side management and energy efficiency. Locomotives with auxiliary load are now being manufactured by us. Use of these locos will enable elimination of power cars, thereby replacing them with passenger coaches, which will enhance the carrying capacity of 10 and significantly reduce the travel time, noise level, fuel consumption and carbon footprint. 4 such locos have been turned in the current financial year and another 39 are expected in the next year. Rail University is an important enabler to build sustained flow of skilled manpower, a prime requisite for any world-class railway system. We identified the National Academy of Indian Railways at Vadodara as the first institution which will be upgraded to a full-fledged university. Preparations are in full swing to establish the university during this year. As an organization, we cannot progress on the path of prosperity unless the path is digitally illuminated. This year, an application of TAC management system was launched. With this, activities of TAC inspection, monitoring and maintenance has thus been switched over to an IT platform. And automatic alerts in the form of SMS and emails are being generated. Inventory management module of TMS has resulted in inventory reduction of 27,000 metric tons, resulting in a saving of 64 crores and scrap identification of 22,000 metric tons, equivalent to 53 crores. During this year, the system will be implemented throughout the railway network. We have developed an application for maintaining centralized land data and records of all land holding that we have now been digitized. As I move on to illustrate the new initiative, let me take a step back. One of the thrust areas of last year's budget was giving passengers better services and making railway journeys enjoyable. We'll continue to build on this momentum and strive hard to ensure satisfaction of each of the 7 billion passengers that ride railway's network annually. Ours is a common man's government, working tirelessly for the benefit of all, especially farmers, workers, women, disabled and the impoverished. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas is not just a slogan for us, it pervades all our thoughts and actions. Every customer is our brand ambassador, the very reasons of our existence. Therefore, each time that he or she travels, the satisfaction quotient must go up. In pursuance of making each of our customers happy, I propose to take the following measures. For the unreserved passengers, we'll start, this is a new product, not a train, this will be there all over, Antyodaya Express and Deen Dayalu coaches. This government truly believes that the fate of India would not change unless the lives of the common man or woman improve. Not only he or she is a center point of policy making, but is ubiquitous to our public discourse and in our ideology. We propose to introduce Antyodaya Express, a long-distance, fully unreserved superfast train service for the common man to be operated on dense routes. We will also add 2 or 4 Deen Dayalu coaches in some long-distance trains for unreserved travel to enhance our carrying capacity for the masses. These coaches will also have facility for potable drinking water and higher number of mobile charging points. For the reserved passengers, we are starting 3 new products. Hum Safar, Tejas and Uday. I am announcing 3 TRELEX services to ensure cost recovery by way of tariff and non-tariff measures. Hum Safar would be fully air-conditioned third AC service with an optional service for meals. Tejas, on the other hand, will showcase the future of train travel in India, operating at a speed of 130 km per hour and above. It will offer onboard services such as entertainment, local cuisine, Wi-Fi, etc. through one service provider for ensuring accountability and improved customer satisfaction. We'll also introduce overnight double-decker Uday Express on the busiest route, which has the potential to increase carrying capacity by almost 40%. To continue the efforts in minimizing waiting time for passengers at booking windows, we intend to commence sale of tickets through handheld terminals for the benefit of the suburban and short-distance travelers. This should enable us to deploy multiple point-of-sales with minimum infrastructure. We also intend initiating sale of platform tickets through ticket vending machine, which will be made compatible with not only cash but also credit and debit cards. In the next 3 months, We open the e-ticketing facility for foreign debit and credit card holder, particularly for the foreign tourists and the NRIs. For our journalist friends, we will provide e-booking of tickets on the concessional passes available to them. This has been a long-pending request, and it is my privilege to provide them with this service, hoping that they will cover it better. Cancellation of PRS tickets requires a passenger to travel to a booking window to avail the refund within a prescribed time. This is a source of great discomfort. We will now open the facility of cancellation through the 139 helpline, post-verification using one-time password sent to registered phone members. We will introduce barcoded tickets, scanners and access control on a pilot basis on major stations to tackle the menace of ticketless travel and ensure hassle-free travel for the genuine passengers. We have taken a number of measures to improve service during the morning Tatkal hours, yet there are complaints of rightful passengers being denied train tickets. We therefore intend to progressively ensure CCTV coverage at all Tatkal counters. We plan to institutionalize a system of third-party periodic audits and certification of security features of the PRS website so it cannot be hacked. The Vikalp Alternative Train Accommodation System scheme, introduced in October 2015, will be expanded to provide choice of accommodation in specific trains to wait-listed passengers. This has been a great response from the people, and we want to increase it. Taking forward the momentum on Swachh Rail, Swachh Bharat, we intend taking a string of measures to improve the cleaner stations and trains. Introducing Clean My Coach service, which is already there, on pan-India basis, where a passenger can request cleaning of the coach or a toilet on a demand through SMS. So then instantly the service will be provided. Ranking of A1 and A-class stations based on a regular periodic third-party audit and feedback from passengers. Setting up of a waste segregation and recycling centers at A1 category station in a phased manner. 5 centers to be commissioned in the next financial year itself. Undertaking awareness campaign, installing additional 30,000 bio toilets, providing portable structures with bio toilets at all platforms for select stations for senior citizens, divyang and women. Catering has been one of the main issues and also source of satisfaction as well as complaint. Catering has been an important parameter for customer satisfaction. In pursuit of our objective to provide quality food to customers, the following measures are taken. IRCTC would begin to manage catering services in a phased manner. IRCTC will unbundle catering services by creating a distinction primarily between food preparation and food distribution. Extending e-catering service from the existing 45 large stations to all 408 A1 and A-class stations. Explore the possibility of making mandatory catering service optional in train. Local cuisine of choice will be made available to the passengers. Adding 10 more IRCTC operated mechanized sophisticated base kitchen to ensure fresh and hygienic supply of food on train. Mandating third-party audit in order to ensure desired level of quality in catering services. Introducing a new policy of multi-purpose as against existing single-purpose stalls at stations where each stall can provide multiple services required by passengers including milk products and OTC medicines. Enforcing reservation in catering unit to scheduled cars, scheduled types, other backward classes, women, divyang, etc. We will also introduce a sub-quota of 33% for women in each of the reserved category. Further, to build local ownership and employment, a process of giving weightage to district domicile holders for commercial licenses at stations would be initiated, as you have seen in the past, that one contractor could pack all the stalls. We are going to be also using all the technical halls as commercial halls on the long distance train. We have introduced Sarthi Seva in Konkan Railway to help the old and disabled passengers requiring assistance at stations. We will expand this service at many more stations. We will strengthen the existing service for enabling passengers to book battery-operated cars, porter services on a paid basis in addition to the existing pickup and drop and wheelchair services. For the divyang, and with the objective of Accessible India campaign, we'll ensure that all stations under redevelopment are accessible to divyang. We will make efforts to provide at least one divyang-friendly toilet in each platform in A1 class.
झी 24 तास रहा एक पाऊल पुढे.